All right, the American Association of Pediatrics releasing new guidelines on screenings for heart conditions in children. Dr. Peter Aziz with the Cleveland Clinic Children's Hospital joining us now with what the new guidelines mean and what parents need to know about the guidelines. Doctor, first of all, thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thank you for having me, Wayne. Good morning.
Good morning. Talk about the guidelines. What's new what are some of the things that parents should do?
Well, I think the guidelines reflect really what the AAP has endorsed in the past. There's a bit of nuances that we'll discuss in a second, but ultimately the AAP just wants to highlight for pediatricians and for parents the same, what red flags there are, what things to watch out for if they ever do come up in your child that would require some more intense medical evaluation.
All right, talk about the ages that we're, what ages are we talking about, and what are some of the things that parents need to look out for?
So the ages really are for any of our pediatric patients, so any of our children, and the cycle at which we want to investigate this really is ongoing, but is a formal process through your pediatrician every 2 or 3 years or so. And the red flags that the AAP discusses that as cardiologists we know very well is things like fainting, so passing out spells, particularly in the context of exertion or emotional stress.
Okay.
That can be a red flag. Things like family history, having a first degree relative, a parent, a sibling that's had a cardiovascular problem or a cardiovascular condition is another prompt for more intense investigation.
Doctor, you mentioned nuances. What are you talking about there?
So in the past, the assignment really for pediatricians and for cardiologists was to really hone in on our athletes. So pre-participation screening for our athletes is something that most of us consider to be kind of a baseline and knee-jerk for our pediatric patients. And now they've extended this beyond just the athletes and said, well, why just the athletes? If any pediatric patient can be at risk, we need to be doing this really across the board. And that's been injected into the new guidelines.
So how, say for instance, what age should you start having your child checked? I mean, is it?
That's a really good question, Wayne. It's actually a moving target. So there are some cardiovascular conditions that present very early on in life, even as newborns, we can sometimes see evidence of that. Whereas there are other cardiovascular conditions, particularly with regard to heart muscle problems, what we call cardiomyopathies, that may not develop until patients are in their teenage years. So even though somebody will pass a screening examination or a screening history when they're young, it doesn't necessarily mean that they got a clean slate throughout their pediatric life. This needs to be reinvestigated every 2 or 3 years.
Doctor, why now? Why are the new guidelines coming out right now?
Well, the timing of it, I think is appropriate just in the sense that as we learn more and as we advocate more for public awareness, we're starting to discover that a lot of these things that seem relatively straightforward, the public doesn't have a good sense of. So educating our pediatricians, educating us as cardiologists, and certainly the community and our parents is the right way to go about this. And documents like this, I think, help get that conversation started.
Does COVID play a part? Did it play a part in the decision to do the guidelines now?
I think that's a fair point, Wayne. I think COVID and cardiovascular questions and the myocarditis, the heart inflammation piece that we've been hearing a lot about during COVID, have all, I think, maybe put this into the forefront. Mm-hmm. One thing that's got recent news attention, of course, during the Euro Cup was the athlete that collapsed and had a cardiovascular arrest and was resuscitated. You know, things of that nature tend to reinvigorate the conversation.
All right. Dr. Aziz, thank you for your time this morning. Dr. Aziz with the Cleveland Clinic Children's Hospital, thank you so much for some very important information as far as our children are concerned. Thank you, sir. Appreciate you.